Welcome to the Google Workspace Developer News, where we share what's new to the Google Workspace platform. We have six topics to cover, so let's get started. You can now build a chat app that understands and responds with natural language using a direct integration between Dialogflow CX and Google Chat API. This integration is currently available through the Developer Preview Program. We are linking a tutorial in the description of this video that will show you how to use the Dialogflow CX and Google Chat API integration to build a chat app. The formatted text field on the message resource includes the markup syntax for bulleted list text formatting. Let's have a look at an example to understand what this update means. Consider the following text sent by a user. If the message was formatted by using the format menu in the chat UI, the text field contains the text only, while the formatted text field contains the markups, the text, and the hyperlink. Your chat app receives the message in the format you see on screen. As you can see, an asterisk followed by a space precedes each list item. Google Chat Apps can now use accessory widgets, which are interactive widgets that appear at the bottom of a message. You can use these widgets to prompt users to interact with your message. On screen, you see an example of the JSON that adds a thumbs up and a thumbs down icon as an accessory widget. The Link Preview class has been added to the AppScript card service. This class lets you control various aspects of link previews, including the Smart Chip title, the Link Preview title, and the Link Preview card. On screen, you see an example of a Google Workspace add-on that lets Google Docs preview links from a third-party service. We are using the Link Preview class to set the title and the Link Preview title. You can now delete multiple unused versions at the same time from the Project History page. To do so, access the Project History view in your script project. You will see the newly added Bulk Delete Versions button. When you click on it, a dialog showing a list of versions that you can delete will appear. Note that versions in use by an active deployment aren't included in the list and can't be deleted. Select the versions you want to delete and click Delete. The default property for the text button style enum in the AppScript card service has been renamed from text to outlined to align with the Google Material 3 design system. Existing scripts that use the original default text render the same as the new default outlined. On screen, you see an example of three buttons using the filled, outlined, and legacy text button style property. Let us know in the comments section below. Which new feature are you most excited about trying out? Make sure to subscribe to this YouTube channel so that you stay up to date with all things Google Workspace platform related.